Joe, you have so many extraordinary gifts. How can you expect to lead an ordinary life? You're ready to go out and find a good use for your talent. Although I don't know what I shall do without my job. Go and embrace your liberty and see what wonderful things come of it.
Laurie sought his refuge in London and abroad. Marmee helped me find a place in the great city of New York, and so I stepped over the divide between childhood and all that lay beyond.
Mrs. Kirk?
Josephine!
Oh, yes, how do you do?
Kitty, Minnie! This is Miss March. Her father was Colonel March. He knew your papa.
Down the Pino where Ballas.
It was cold.
Watch your feet, Mr. Costigan.
Get it straight.
Oh, do come in, my dear.
Oh, you're making that up. What if
you... Dear Beth, Marmee's friend, Mrs. Kirk, has made me feel quite at home. My little students, Kitty and Minnie, are dear girls. How curious to grow up in a busy boarding house with no father and your own mother, the innkeeper. I felt bold on leaving Concord, but I confess I find New York rough and strange, and myself strange in it.
Every night, thank you kindly, Professor.
Mrs. Kirk believes that I am here for a brief interlude of sensational experience before succumbing to a matrimonial fate. And while there is surely no lack of sensational experience of every kind available in such a city, I hope, though I've had no luck yet, that any experience I gain here will be strictly literary, and that all events of a romantic or sensational nature will be entirely confined to the page.
Our subscribers are not interested in sentiment and fairy stories, miss.
They're not fairy stories.
Try one of the ladies' magazines.